Hello, my name is Artem Barsky. I'm co-founder of Dateerium. Today, I'm going to show you how to add data to your side-up projects. So first, you need to enter the project. So click on the project name. And here is the plus button, which allows you to add new experiments. So here on top, you need to decide what is the experiment. In this case, I want to add a ChIP-seq experiment, which was sequenced as a single read. So I select this pipeline, and now I can give experiment the information about experiment. So this is done in, this is going to be June B chip. It is has been done in T cells. They have been activated for 5 hours. Here you can put the catalog number of antibody for your records. And you need to select the genome. We are going to use the latest Homo sapiens genome, HG38. You can also define a control experiment, for example, your input. We are not going to do it in this case. The next step is to attach raw data. So today we're going to take raw data from our published paper, and I'm going to show you how to do it. But alternatively, you can upload files from your computer. So you can go to select file from your device. You can get the files from the satellite, or if core facility is connected, you can take data directly from core facility. The option we're going to use is data from URL or from GEO database. So we're going to use published data. So let's go to the GEO database. So here we are in GEO. We can search, for example, by author name. So I'm going to search by my name, or you can search by your molecule of interest. So we find the project. So this project includes a lot of data. We are going to look at ChIP-seq data. So we are going to ChIP-seq subseries here. And here is the list of samples. So we are going to do JuneB. So this is our sample of interest. You can read the description here. But what you need to find is the SRR number, the short read archive number. So you go here, and this is the number that you need. So let's copy it. Also here you can read the information about the sample. So it is ChIP-seq, single read, and you could also see the information about antibodies, for example, somewhere here. Okay, let's go back to side-up and enter the data source. So for GEO samples, we just enter GEO colon, two slashes, and followed by SRR number. If there are more than one SRR, then you can separate them by comma. At this point, we can click attach button, and the data will be downloaded as needed. Okay, what are the other options? So we can select broad peak calling for data like HTK27 trimethylation, which forms broad peaks. You can also force to use some fragment size. You can clip from one or both ends. You can select to remove duplicates or not. And then you can select number of threads to use. At this point, we are done. And we can save sample. So this will sync and start processing. And in the next video, we will look at the results of data analysis and talk about results interpretation. Thank you, and see you in the next video.